Doing good.
I'm not doing bad at all.
You always appear very serious, you know. I mean,
sure.
Do you smile? Do you have any fun side?
I do. I smile a lot. If you ask my colleagues in our inner circles, I can create a lot of laughter.
Oh, really?
Well, we'll see if we can have some of that laughter tonight.
We'll have
some.
Awesome.
But before we start, I mean, we have UF here. They brought some drinks. So apparently they have Tosi and they have Burkina. Wow. So what can we offer you?
Who?
This is tradition, you know.
Wow.
We don't have cola.
Yeah. Maybe we can do that later.
Oh, no, we are taking our West now, so.
I am taking a couple of the Tosi. So.
No, okay. A calabash.
No, there's a calabash. Wow.
Yes.
Wow. Awesome.
So Tosi is fine.
Well, what I will do.
We are spoiling the fun.
Oh, sorry. You know, I'm not food fan.
Really?
If I could give you any of my wife's number, call.
Wait, how many wives do you have?
I have two.
We'll talk about that later.
What is my favorite food? You struggle. The senior one, 23 years, and she will not be able to tell you.
Really?
Yes. The second one, almost 10 years. Because I'm not fan.
Is there any special reason?
Yeah.
Well, maybe because of the poverty I grew in from.
So you ran from food.
But now
life's so good.
Getting used to doing things without food.
Yeah, but now there's goodie,
life is good.
But you know, that's how life can be funny. I mean, when you are poor, you can't afford. When you can't afford, they say for medical reasons, check this, check that.
Exactly.
Do this. So you don't know. My mother will say, oh, after all this wahala, this small chicken I want to eat, they say I should not eat. After death, it will come when it will come. So
it chills more. So whilst we are waiting for our drinks, tell us about Muntaka. Who is Muntaka?
Well, interestingly, Muntaka is my surname.
Oh, wow. Okay, so your first name is?
Yes, Mohammed Mubarak. It's Mohammed. A company.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, Mohammed Mubarak is my name.
But we love Muntaka.
Muntaka is much easier to
carry. Yeah, carries the weight.
Yes,
exactly.
That's my surname. Yeah, I mean, I'm really very a privileged person. Mm. When I say privileged, I mean, if you look at the pit
where
I had to struggle to come up, I almost didn't believe I would be where I am. Wow. I mean, my hope. Once growing was my children could get to where I am. I didn't give myself the least of chance to get here. I mean, 14th born of my father, first born of my mother. I mean, in Ababu, where we don't go to school, we only go
Ababu
to
Ababu in Ashanti region.
Yes, Ababu okay. Extension, not far away from the airport.
Okay.
I mean, you go taking care of the cattle, my father's cattle. You
thank you.
You go to Makaranta. You go hawk, support my mother. My mother was a cocoa seller, so you help her to prepare the cocoa and sell it. And you know, in our community, I'm called the lad, a Sunday birth.
Okay.
And I'm the firstborn. The second one is also a boy. The third is a boy. The fourth is a boy.
Wow.
The fifth is a boy.
Ooh.
Okay.
The sixth became then comes a girl.
Okay.
So I have to learn to do everything that a female girl would normally do to assist the mother. So I mean, and you are 10 years. Your colleagues are in class 4, and it's like you will not go to school. Then miracles happen, then the old man changes his mind. But I would think we have to try it. So over you are almost past the age.
Yeah.
Because you go at 7, 8. No, you are almost 11. So after you there is like
past the school board.
Yeah,
age.
You pass the but they will laugh at you because you are tall. They will laugh at you. So better concentrate and let's take care of the animals. I'll give it a try. And you start with the one after you, the one after that one, the one after, I mean, 5 siblings.
Mm-hmm.
You start the same day in the class and you are the tallest in the class and everybody is laughing at you. And it's like, hey, can I really march on? Well, and you keep marching on till you finish your master's. I mean, this is no child's play.
So which school was this?
I mean, I started at Ababu LA, Ababu MA Primary. Then went to Calvira International, then Central International, then Tamale Secondary School. So I went to 3 primary schools.
Yeah. Okay.
As my mother's income level changes. then yeah. the school also changes.
Yeah. Mm.
So because obviously by the time I was growing, my father was old. Mm. I mean, I was his 14th born. So
yeah,
wow.
yeah obviously. Yeah.
So Temole Secondary School, O-level, then Technology Secondary School to do sixth form, mm. then KNUST to do the first degree, mm. and then back to KNUST to do the master's. And the last time I was in school was 2004.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yes. So it's not been easy, but very interesting. Mm. I mean, and I remember when we were in sixth form, and Technology Secondary School is a day school. Mm. And around the cabin, there's a private hostel. So you try to go there, and I mean, you don't have anybody supporting you. Mm. So the struggle to even feed yourself. Mm. And I tell you, you eat something once in a day.
Mm. So what about your older siblings? Mm-hmm.
You know, we're in a polygamous home. And my father had a total of seven. My mother was a third wife. Mm. So the other siblings, you know, the rivalry in the home.
Mm. Yeah.
Uh-huh. And it's like the first wife had nine children, only one boy.
Mm.
And the second one had four, only one boy. And these were really very senior to us.
Mm.
So, and I mean, with all humility, my sisters are pretty. So they get married early.
No, you are handsome. So it's understandable.
My sisters are pretty. So they get married early. So it's like most of the time, all of them are not around.
Mm.
My mother ran in the house for 7 years without giving birth.
Really?
And almost the family, like, oh, you see, I have other children, and this is my sister. She says she's not giving birth. Should we divorce so that she could go and marry somewhere and have children? And my grandfather would say, no, I'm telling you, the time will come. The time will come. Then the time came, and they gave birth to me. I had sight problem. I had hearing problem. I could not speak till I was four.
Wow.
What happened?
Like, what kind of child is this?
Wow.
Is this really going to survive?
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes when people are at my neck, oh, remove him. I say, you don't know the circumstances of my birth. If you don't know my birth, you know the same what they are saying.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, we are grateful to God. The old man is dead. I mean, he died he died on my wedding day.
Oh.
Some 23 years ago. In the Zongos, the marriage starts on Thursday.
Yeah.
So the lady will be isolated. For the lele and the ceremony starts then Friday, Saturday, then the ceremony will happen on Sunday.
Mm.
So my first wife had gone into isolation Thursday. Then Friday we wake up, the old man was not feeling well. And it's like, oh, we have to go back to the hospital. Then we're there around 8:30 p.m. They came, I couldn't believe it. The old man is gone.
Wow.
And the imam says, no, the two ceremonies, none can cancel the other. So they must go concurrently.
Wow.
So the wedding is going on, burial also has to take place.
But you know, interestingly, it brought something that I keep telling my constituents.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All the plan party and all those things have to be cancelled off.
Mm-hmm.
And believe me, that became the foundation of our business. So my first wife and I, we have a business called Mubzi. The M-U-B is Mubarak.
Yeah.
And then the Z is Zainab. So we have Mubzi.
Okay.
And the business is up to date, doing very well.
So what is the business?
Started, mm-hmm. We started with that seed money.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
We first started with, because I was in KNUST, Adjusty Gate, so we started with photocopying. Mm. It moves to typesets. Mm. Then it moves to laminating, binding. Then internet came. We started an internet cafe.
Whilst you were a student?
Yeah.